Was Manute Bol actually good? When you're 7 feet 7 inches, the first thing people are going to ask you when you walk by is if you play in the NBA. Manute Bol did play in the NBA strictly because of his height. Bol didn't possess many skills other than shot blocking, was slow running up the court, and was potentially 50 years old when he retired on the court. There are also rumors that Bol might have been drunk on the court because the Philadelphia 76ers wanted him to gain weight. Manute's story sounds bogus, and that's why it's a story that we'll talk about forever. Keep watching to see if Manute Bol was actually good. NBA's tallest player. Manute Bol was standing at 7 feet and 7 inches, and to this day is still one of the tallest players in NBA history. Bol made NBA history with more blocks than points in his entire career. So was Manute Bol actually good? Remember, Manute Bol died in 2010 at the age of 47, but he might have been a lot older than 47 when he passed away. His head coach at Cleveland State, Kevin Mackey, believed Bol was much older than people thought he was. After recruiting him for Cleveland State upon his arrival to the States, Bol didn't know what his actual age was. Mackey made up a date for his birthday and said nobody knew how old he was at the time. I gave him his birthday because they didn't know how old he was. Bol had no idea of his age, and the kid who came over with him didn't know how old he was. No one knew how old he was. What is even crazier is that Mackey thinks Bol might have been in his early 40s when he came to the US back in 1984. Bol never actually played for Cleveland State because of enrollment issues, but Mackey remembers the fact that he was probably much older than what was believed by everyone. I wanted to make sure he was young enough because he didn't have an age. I think he was in his 40s, I really do, but there's no way of ever really knowing. Every athletic door is open at 19. Every athletic door is closed when you're 35. He was probably 40, 50 years old when he was playing in the NBA. Imagine 50-year-old Bol getting minutes in the NBA. Bol ended his NBA career with the Golden State Warriors in 1995 and was probably or potentially a 50-year-old and still playing in the NBA. There were several similar stories in different sports about players presenting themselves to be younger than they are so they get a contract. With Bol, it's easy to point fingers and say that he was lying. However, maybe he really didn't know. Either way, it's hard not to know if you're alive for 20 or 40 years. You just know. Nevertheless, if that might be the case with Bol and his age, it's even more fascinating if he was able to play in the NBA at the age of 40 and 50 and still be a solid role player. He worked on his craft and is still to this day remembered as one of the best shot blockers in NBA history. His son Bol Bol was selected by the Miami Heat with the 44th pick in the NBA draft. He was later traded to the Denver Nuggets and hasn't made his debut in the NBA as he's currently in the G League. Jason Williams. Every casual fan knew who Manute Bol was, or at least knew of him. That's because the man was standing at 7'7" and played center for 4 teams. The teams included the Washington Bullets, Golden State Warriors, Philadelphia 76ers, and Miami Heat. Everyone loves a good shot blocker, and Bol, who averaged more block shots than points, was famous for shot blocking around the rim, thanks to his wingspan. Bol grew up in Sudan, which is now South Sudan, and tended to his family's cattle in rural Turole during his youth. Rumors have swirled around saying that Bol speared and killed a lion that was attacking the herd. Bol also donated plenty of his NBA salary to nonprofits in Sudan. After his retirement from the NBA, Bol was extremely active around the world with celebrity boxing to playing hockey, to fundraise for his Ring True Foundation and other organizations. Bol was an impressive human being, but many are still curious about his life. Jason Williams, the former New Jersey Nets power forward, had some interesting things to say about Bol in a 2016 radio interview. Williams played with Bol during the 1990-1992 seasons for the Philadelphia 76ers. He told Vice Sports that they tried to attempt to put some weight on Bol, who only weighed 180 pounds when he entered the NBA, but they were unsuccessful. Because of this, the 76ers were creative and reckless. They used to let Manute Bol drink the whole time, so he would drink Heinekens all day long to help put on weight. So Manute Bol never played sober in one basketball game. Do you believe this? A bottle of Heinekens has 150 calories, and it's not a great addition to any man's diet, especially in the NBA. There's plenty of other options for Bol to drink other than beer. Imagine letting a player play drunk in today's game. That's disgusting. Don't you wish we could actually confirm this? Bol was also very proud of his manhood and enjoyed giving it some air and letting it out free. Listen to what Williams had to say. He used to put on all his clothes last, so what he would do after he got out of the shower, he would put on his socks, and then that was it. And then he would just walk around the locker room naked drinking Heinekens. Williams also alleges, like everyone else, that Bol, who was 28 when he started with the 76ers in 1990, was much older than that. He used to say that he was 35 years old, but I used to be on the bench looking at all those circles and scars around his head, explained Williams, and I asked him one day, Manute, what are those scars on your head? And he says, well, the white man lost my birth certificate in the jungle, so every 5 years, I take a rock and I slice one across my head. I was like, all right. And then I started looking at the next game and I said, holy crap. Manute Bol is 55 years old. If Williams is serious, Bol wasn't 47 when he died in 2010. He was more like 70. Bol Bol. 20 years ago, the political activist and humanitarian Manute Bol was accused of being an American spy. He was blocked by his native Sudanese government from escaping to the United States. 4 years later, Bol and his family, including son Bol Bol, moved to America as designated political refugees. Bol Bol said his father cared more about others than he did himself. In 2018, Bol Bol played for Team USA with a group of elite American high school seniors against a team of international teenagers in the Nike Hoop Summit in Portland, Oregon. Bol Bol scored 12 points and grabbed a team-high 14 rebounds in Team USA's 89-76 loss to the World Select Team. Bol Bol wished his father could watch him play. It means a lot to represent the country, and to also be one of 13 selected to play, Bol Bol said. Honestly, I am happy to be on the USA team. Bol Bol hopes to follow his father's footsteps by helping others in Sudan. Manute Bol once held an $80 a month job in the Sudanese military. Manute played on the national team, according to USA Today. At the time, then Fairleigh Dickinson University basketball coach Don Feely saw Manute Bol play basketball in Khartoum, Sudan, and was able to persuade him to go to the United States. USA Today wrote a 1985 story on Bol with the headline, Scouts, Bol has a slim chance of success. Eventually, Bol was selected with the 31st overall pick in the 1985 draft by the Washington Bullets, out of the Division II University of Bridgeport. Manute Bol was selected to the 1986 All-NBA Defensive Second Team, after averaging 2.6 points, 4.2 rebounds, and 3.3 blocks for his career. He led the league in blocks in the 1985-1986 season with Washington at 5 per game, and in the 1988-1989 season with Golden State at 4.3 a game. Of course, he was able to do this because he was also one of the tallest players in NBA history. I've seen a couple of videos, basketball and documentary type of stuff about him, Bol Bol told The Undefeated. Manute Bol earned $5.8 million during his NBA career, according to Basketball Reference, and again, gave a lot of that money to the Southern Rebels to fight against the government in Sudan's largest city, Khartoum. After plenty of decades with long religious and tribal fighting that killed many of Manute Bol's relatives, Bol still had a dream of building 41 schools in Sudan, where Muslims, Christians, and various tribes would study together. But on June 19, 2010, Bol died from acute kidney failure and complications from Stevens-Johnson syndrome. This is a disorder of the skin and mucous membranes. Thankfully, the charity organization Sudan Sunrise had stayed committed to fulfilling Bol's dream. He did a lot of great things on the court, but most people remember him because of what he did off of it, helping schools and building hospitals. He did some really good things back home, Bol Bol said. I'm probably most proud of what he did helping my family and everything he did in Africa. It's probably the best thing he did. Not too many people could do what he did, but he just fought through everything and did what he could do. Manute Bol had 10 children and left them behind when he was buried in his native Sudan. Bol Bol attended his father's funeral and his lone trip to Sudan when he was 10 years old. I was born there, but I moved when I was 2, Bol Bol said. It was really cool. I was only 10 when I went back, but I got to see everything my dad was doing. It was cool to see where I was born. Bol Bol said that he has always loved basketball, despite a previous story stating that his father had to beg him to become interested in playing the sport. Bol Bol said before his father died, he told him to work hard to continue to improve as a basketball player. Bol Bol said he truly fell in love with basketball when he was in the 7th grade, and his first basketball mixtape went viral online. It was the first time the world really saw me play, Bol Bol said. I just got a lot of positive feedback, and made me like basketball even more. Bol Bol was ranked as a 5-star recruit and the 4th best prospect overall in the class of 2018 by ESPN. He said he chose to play for Oregon over Kentucky, Duke, and St. John's, after building a good relationship with the coaching staff, while also appreciating their style of play and facilities. Like his father, Bol Bol is a great shot blocker, but he has so much more to offer from an offensive standpoint. Bol Bol said he wanted to work on his strength and being more physical. Bol Bol has the potential to be an impact player at every level he plays, USA coach Mike Jones said. To be his size and possess the skill that he does is unbelievable. He can shoot, handle the ball, and score around the rim. His ability to affect the game on the defensive end is special. Bol Bol sat out most of his season with Oregon due to injury, but was later drafted by the Denver Nuggets in the 2nd round at pick 44. Still, even with being in the NBA, Bol Bol wants to finish what his father started, and not just in the NBA. When I can go back to Sudan, I definitely will, Bol Bol said. Later on, I plan on going back and finishing everything he started. But that is later in the future. It is where I was born, so I have to go back and visit. My father cared about other people more than himself. That is one thing I remember from my dad. Manute Bol was a caring father who sacrificed a ton for his family and his country. He didn't make tons of fortunes, but he made sure to pass on his earnings to better help other people in need. His stats weren't crazy. His length, side, and wingspan were crazy. Averaging more blocks than points is ridiculous on its own. He likely wouldn't make it in today's game, but when he played, there were less three-point balls and more shots near the rim. This allowed Manute Bol to block plenty of shots and be a factor in games even if he couldn't do much offensively. Bol was very slow up and down the court, and knowing that he might have been a drunk 50-year-old on the court, it all kind of makes sense. Bol was one of the tallest players in NBA history, couldn't gain weight, lied about his age, and got drunk during his basketball games. The reality is, even if coaches and players didn't know how old Manute Bol was, he knew more than he shared. Manute Bol likely died older than 47. 47 seems too young for any athlete to pass away so quickly. It's also wild to think about how Manute Bol was able to add 10 children to his family. When you're tall, the women must flock towards you. He was very proud of his manhood, and likely showed it off more times than not to the ladies. He was an interesting fellow back in the day, but he's got nothing on Wilt Chamberlain. But we can still respect Manute. All this, and he was able to support his family and help his son Bol Bol reach higher limits than himself. Manute Bol wasn't a great basketball player, but he made a name for himself with his shot blocking ability. He also gave us the special gift in Bol Bol, who is going to be a solid asset to the Nuggets in the near future.